The most basic arithmetic operation is succession. Succession is the sum of 1 to a number. The letter above is addition. Addition is repeated succession. A plus B is equal to adding up away B times. Then we have multiplication. Multiplication is repeated addition. A times B is equal to adding A to itself, B times. The letter above multiplication is exponentiation. Exponentiation is repeated multiplication. A to the power of B is equal to N multiplied by itself, B times. The next operation probably many people don't know about. Iteration. Iteration is repeated exponentiation. A to the B is equal to A raised to the power of itself, B times. In other words, it is a power of exponents with the height of B. Iteration is a very powerful operation that can generate incredibly large numbers. For example, 3 iterated to 4 is a power of 4 threes. To evaluate that iteration, we always start from the top. So 3 to the power of 3 is 27. 3 to the power of 27 is already equal to more than 7 trillion. Multiplying 3 by itself this many times results in a gigantic number. This number has over 3 trillion digits. With just the numbers 3 and 4, iteration can create numbers that are so enormous that it's hard for us even to imagine them. But iteration doesn't always have to generate numbers this big. 1 iterated to any number is always a 1. Even if we have an infinite power of 1s, it's still just 1. This is a trivial example, but now consider an infinite power of square roots of 2. We can write it as the square root of 2 iterated to infinity. But the more accurate way to express it would be using a limit as x approaches infinity of the square root of 2 iterated to x. Surprisingly, this infinite power converges to 2. The limit exists when we iterate a number that's between e to the power of minus e and e to the power of 1 over e, which is an interval from around 0.07 to 1.44, the square root of 2 plus within this range. So far, we've written the equation using direct exponents. Unfortunately, there is no standard notation for the equation, but two upper arrows are used very often, and this notation will allow us to express even higher level operations beyond the equation. The arrow notation can be also used to write exponentiation. A to the power of b can be written as a upper arrow b. With this notation, we can define an operation to level 5, using three arrows with a note pentation. Just like the equation is repeated exponentiation, pentation is repeated iteration. A pentated to b is equal to a pentated to itself, b times. 3 pentated to 3 is equal to 3 pentated to 3 pentated to 3, and 3 pentated to 3 is equal to 3 to the power of 3 to the power of 3, and this is equal to more than 7 trillion. And 3 pentated to this number is a power of 3 of height more than 7 trillion. This number is unimaginably massive. But we can go a little higher. With 4 arrows, we can denote hexation. Hexation is repeated pentation. 3 hexated to 3 is equal to 3 pentated to 3 pentated to 3. This number can be compared to anything in the real world. With this giant number, we can start computing a Graham's number, which is one of the most famous big numbers. To construct it, we start by defining that 3 hexated to 3 is equal to G0. Hexation is denoted using only 4 arrows and already generates enormous numbers, but G1 is equal to 3 followed by G0 number of arrows and another 3. Just imagine how big this number is. Next we have G2, which is denoted using G1 number of arrows. G3 is equal to 3, G2 number of arrows, and 3. This sequence continues until we get to the G63. It is equal to 3 followed by G62 arrows and 3. That is the Graham's number. Graham's number was used by Ronald Graham as a simplified explanation of the upper bound of the problem he was working on. At the time of its introduction, it was the largest specific positive integer ever to have been used in a published mathematical proof. In 1980, Graham's number was described in the Guinness Book of World Records. Since then, many bigger numbers have appeared in mathematical proofs. For example, the Graham's number is extremely small in comparison to the tree of 3. To explain what this number is, we need to play a game of trees. In this game, we try to create a forest using colored seeds, calling it 2 rows. The nth tree can have more than n seeds. The first tree can have only 1 seed, the next can have more than 2, and so on. The second rule is that when you try to build a tree, it cannot contain any of the earlier trees within itself. For example, this tree contains this one, so it cannot be built. Also, the tree is contained in another tree, and they preserve the nearest common ancestor rule. In this tree, the nearest common ancestor of the yellow and red seeds is the green seed. In the other tree, the nearest common ancestor of the yellow and red seeds is also the green seed. It means that the first tree is contained in the second tree, so the second tree cannot be built. The tree of n function tells us how many trees we can build using n colors of seeds. Using one color, we can only build one tree, because the first tree will have one seed, and any further trees will contain this tree. So tree of 1 is equal to 1. When we have two colors of seeds, red and green, the first tree has one red seed, the next can have n red seeds because it will contain the first tree, so we can use two green seeds. We build the next tree, we still can't use the red seeds, we also can use more than two green seeds. But the third tree can have at most three seeds, so we can have only one seed, and it can only be a green seed to not contain any of the previous trees. We can build any more trees, so 3 of 2 is equal to 3. Using three colors of seeds, we start with a tree that has only one seed. Then we can have this tree, then another one, and all of them obey the rules of the game. And we can go on and on, and build more and more trees. The total number of trees we can build using three colors of seeds is equal to 3 of 3. This number is massive even when compared to Graham's number, but we know that it is finite. Graham's number, denoted as G63, is a colossal number, but we don't have to stop at G63, we can keep going. G64 is defined as 3 followed by G63 arrows and another 3. We can even create numbers like G100, G1000, or even G1000000. But none of them would even come close to the tree of 3. We know that tree of 3 is a lot bigger than G3 followed by this many arrows and another 3. The tree function generates incredibly massive numbers. Tree of 4 is already a lot bigger than tree of 3. We can put any number into the tree function. Just imagine how big would be tree of Graham's number, or tree of 3, or tree of Graham's number. These numbers are beyond all comprehension in terms of size.